Tucker has principles, obviously. He speaks about them regularly. This would have been a great opportunity for him to ask the former president and leading Republican candidate about some of those principles. He didn't do any of it. Instead, he sort of, I mean, how soft were the softballs that Tucker was throwing to Donald Trump? He asked Donald Trump to rip on Mike Pence by suggesting that Donald Trump had always been very nice to Mike Pence. This question is so bizarre. I don't even know what to say about this.
Tucker Carlson's interview with Donald Trump was so bad, even conservatives like Ben Shapiro are criticizing it. But here's a little bit more of Ben Shapiro apparently in disbelief that a grifting conservative did exactly what grifting conservatives do.
It's Tucker's question that's absurd. You've always been nice to Mike Pence? The actual f- what? You've what? Oh, hey. Okay, for those who have a memory of a goldfish, let me remind you of a time when Donald Trump suggested, nay, said outright that Mike Pence had the unilateral capacity to overthrow an American election, essentially called him a coward, suggested that he would be forced to do so. And then when Mike Pence called him from the Capitol building on January 6th, because the Capitol building was under assault, he basically did nothing. You were always very nice to Mike Pence is one of the craziest Orwellian statements I have ever heard. You were always very nice to Mike Pence is an insane statement.
And Ben Shapiro even went so far as to suggest the questions that should have been asked. So one was the question to Trump should be, okay, how are you going to unsteal it? Right? That's like a question that whether you love Trump, whether you hate Trump, like that's a really good question that Trump has never answered. You say the election was stolen in 2020, but you won, but it was stolen, but you won. So let's say the same thing happens this time. What is your plan to unsteal the election? Is that the question Tucker asked? No, he asked him questions like, why are people so mean to you? Although personally, I think the question that should be asked is, can you provide us with evidence that the election was stolen from you? But Ben Shapiro rounded up his segment by describing the interview between Tucker and Trump with the same word that I've incidentally been using to describe the Ben Shapiro show for years, propaganda.
No, that's not counter-programming. I'm sorry. That really is not. I mean, it's just a propaganda 45-minute softball for Trump. That's all that is. I mean, just realistically speaking, that you may love it. Maybe that's your bag, but that's what it is. And that, how are you simultaneously so brave and yet so humble? And that's what that interview was.
I mean, he's being hyperbolic, but Cenk, that is exactly what the interview was like.
I don't even think it's hyperbolic. I think it's pretty much exactly what happened. So that's two times in the last week I've agreed with Ben Shapiro. So check whatever multiverse you're in. He said the Fox News rules on what you could do in showing the clips was crazy. And he's totally right. They had all these crazy restrictive rules about the debate that made no sense. And now he's calling out Tucker Carlson for that ridiculous softball interview. Left-wing pivot? I don't think it's a left-wing pivot, and I don't want to make fun of someone for being rational and right. I'll take it. I'm happy to take it. I'm curious if it'll last, though, because remember, Shapiro was a little bit of a never-Trumper in the beginning. Then once Trump won and his audience roared and said, no, we want you to be his, you know, server, then Shapiro served him for years and years and years. And look, I'll give Ben this. He's way too smart to not realize what a pathological liar and criminal Donald Trump is. And I bet he's super frustrated at the 28 different laws that Trump broke for no goddamn reason. And then he had to sit there and defend him on all of those when he knows full well that he's a criminal and a pathological liar and a narcissist. But a little bit of a shift now in saying that that Tucker should ask tough questions of Trump. That is correct, and I'll take it and see how long it lasts. I don't know if it'll be a day, a week, but I would be shocked if Donald Trump won the primary and Ben Shapiro continued to criticize him. Let's see what happens.
What I liked about that was how Ben Shapiro started it. Oh, Tucker, we know, has principles. He talks about them all the time, which, oh yeah, that's the way you demonstrate that you have principles, just by talking about them, not living them. I mean, just look at this. Tucker's a guy who has pretended now for years to be an opponent of the elites. He's going to fight the elites from the right. And what did he do since he launched that branding campaign? He acquiesced to every request that Trump had, gave him airtime repeatedly, helped, you know, together they got Tucker's son an internship in Trump's White House. They are buddy-buddy together. And then you see here a 45-minute softball interview. This isn't a guy with principles. This is a guy who knows his role in conservative media. Even though he's not at Fox anymore, he's still going to play the same role until somebody else starts funding him. Maybe he already has a funder, who knows? But this is like from the very premise, Ben Shapiro could have just ended that commentary. Oh, this guy does not have principles. He's just doing PR. But one really funny thing about that interview, I don't know if you saw the clip, was when Tucker asked Trump, "Do you think Epstein killed himself?" And Trump's response, not yes, no, not oh, that guy's terrible. His very first response to that question was, "Well, I know he was really popular in Palm Beach." Yeah, man, that's what everyone thinks about Jeffrey Epstein, is just how popular he was in Palm Beach. I really enjoyed that clip, and I hope if you haven't seen it yet, you have time to go see it.
Yeah, it's on our YouTube channel. Don't worry. and the reason he said that is because he loved Jeffrey Epstein, and I read the quote when we covered the interview where Trump said, "Oh, he's a terrific guy," and it's said that he likes women as much as I do, except he likes them much younger. Oops. So that's why when Tucker asked him that, he's like, I don't know what happened to Jeffrey. I mean, and remember, it happened under Trump's watch, and Trump was great friends with Epstein. I mean, Tucker loves conspiracy theories. Do you like that one? Okay, but last two things here. The question I would ask Trump, there's 1,000 questions I'd ask him, but one of them along the lines of what Shapiro was mentioning is, then why did you, if you have all this evidence and you have your 2,000 mules and a Kraken, why did you lose 60 cases in a row? Why did 60 judges, a lot of them appointed by you, all rule against you and all say that you have zero evidence? I don't know that he's ever directly been asked that. And then finally, look, if Shapiro's making a pivot, not to the left wing, but to honesty and to honestly criticize his own side as well as the other side while still being an ardent right winger, I would greatly welcome that. And because, I mean, it hasn't happened in decades where a right wing host is actually super conservative, but still honest. There's a couple of guys around the edges, John Ziegler, Joe Walsh, but among the major right wing media hosts, it is a shocking development when they're honest, even one time. So I don't want to discourage it, I want to encourage it. Keep going, Ben. Thanks for watching the Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.